So we have discussed about the plagiarism and some integrity in the research. Now, definitely we need to discuss how to avoid the plagiarism. In a common or in a very straightforward way, if anyone is writing from his own language, using his own language, and at that point of time, avoiding plagiarism will be quite easy. But anyhow, because the main reason for incidence is only because you are dependent on the source. So, in that case, if you are writing something, who is and that writing is dependent on some sources, some references. So there are many things, there are many ways where how you can avoid the plagiarism. Now, there are two broader methods. First method is simply prevention, prevent the practice of plagiarism. And second, if there is a chance, you can go for the detection of the plagiarism. Now, prevention involves, first step is collaborative effort to recognize and counter plagiarism at every level. When you are writing anything, you should be very much concerned how you are exactly avoiding the, or what you can say, taking your best effort not to incorporate the plagiarism. Second thing, usually what is common thing that we educate the students about the appropriate use of intellectual material. When you are writing anything, you should be writing by your own knowledge. So in spite of taking a knowledge from a source, just have this thing in your mind, what exactly the source is saying, and then you are utilizing the knowledge with the use of proper reference. And third, that the institutes should be discouraging, and students should be discouraged to the submission of plagiarized material. So if anyone is actually trying to do that thing, so it should be this practice should be discouraged. Now, this is the very common thing which we are talking about, and almost in every organization, this has now become a rule where things are going in such a way. Now, any case, if there is involvement of a source, the chances of plagiarism is actually there. And now we can say that there are four stages of detection. It's from Culmin and Langster. And first is the collection, second analysis, third confirmation, and fourth investigation. Now, detection actually is important because a person should be aware that if taking all the precautions, all the preventions, there are chance of any type of plagiarism. So we can go for the next stage, that is the detection of the plagiarism. There are actually two techniques. We have to understand this thing, in which the primary is text based. So this technique actually identifies the text which has already been written, the text which has already been mentioned, and if anyone is trying to take that thing as such or in a modified form, this can detect that. Second is actually source code based, where it is trying to identify the main references from which the plagiarism has been done, or from which the or those which are used as a source. Text base is quite can easily understand. Substring matching, small keywords similarity, exact fingerprint match, how the pattern is being, and text parsing. Now, substring matching is simply try to identify maximum matches in pairs. Then they are used as plagiarism indicators. Graph-based measures are then employed to capture the fractions of the plagiarized sections. So what they are doing, they are trying to see the matches, how much they are being done from any source, and substring matching is actually involving that thing. Keyword similarity Obviously, when we are writing anything, we are writing based on some keywords and exact topic identifying keywords from a document. Compare with keywords of the other documents, and if similarity exceeds a certain threshold. So, document is usually divided in small pieces and then compared recursively. So, this is done because it is actually targeting if any keyword is being repeated and that keyword is being compared with other sources where that keyword is used, and in that case, it is being identified. Now, if you talk about the fingerprint match. So, here what they are doing, they are going for a fingerprint match in next technique. So, what they do, they partition the document into sequences, and these called as chunks. Now, there are digital registers, they are computerized, and that form the document fingerprints, small patches, and these digests inserted into hash tables. Then there is what you can say matching, exact matching of the sequences. So, what they try to do, they try to identify the pattern which is actually being repeated. They take that pattern as a fingerprint, and now they try to match that fingerprint. So, something you can say it is expensive, and smaller chunk size are selected to identify matching passages. And what they do, they in text parsing, they actually form a tree, and that is reflected in the structure. Example, we can take the monkey ate the banana. So now they actually say where this is taken from, in which sequence this is taken from, and if the different words are taken from a similar source. So these which is being done. Now, if you talk about online tools, we have to take some examples also, and there are many softwares: PlagAware, PlagScan, Authenticate, CheckForPlagism.net, Turnitin and Urkun, and plagiarismdetection.org. So, we will see if we can give the demo of any of these softwares. Basically, there are two softwares, Turnitin and Urkun, that they are actually being used for the research work in our institute, in our organization. So, we will see the reports that is being generated through that. Now, we can go for the small details of these. PlagAware, it is online service for plagiarism detection. It can search, find, analyze the trace plagiarism in the specific topic similar to that topic. It's a search engine. It provides different type of report that help the user to decide that this document has plagiarized or not. And it is used in academics. Multiple document comparison can be done, but it does not support synonym and sentence structure checking. PlagScan, online software for textual plagiarism checker. Complex algorithm it applies for checking, analyzing, uploaded document. Unique signature extracted from the document's structure, then it is compared with the PlagScan database and millions of the online document. And it can detect most of the plagiarism type, either direct copy or paste or word switching. This can be detected. And it can support many languages that use the international UTF-8 coding, and all languages with the Latin and Arabic characters. CheckForPlagiarism.net, it is again online plagiarism checker that used to stop or prevention online plag. It is using fingerprint based approach, used to analyze and summarize collection of document and create a kind of fingerprint for it, and uses its own database that includes millions of the documents and article over www world wide web, and it supports synonym and sentence structure checking and compare set of different document simultaneously with the other document. Authenticate, it is one of the widely used software, and it is actually for the publishers. So large publishing houses are using this thing. And it has own database that contain millions of documents, and users who have account can do either online and offline comparison of the submitted document against it, and to identify plagiarized content. and it is usually considered as the first online black checker, and it can support more than 30 languages. It may not support synonym and sentence structure checking. Plagiarismdetection.org, it is online service, provides high level of accuracy, result in plagiarism detection. It is having own database that contains million of the documents. English language and all languages that is using Latin character are being supported by this. It is not including multiple document comparison, and it is not supporting synonyms and sentence structure checking. So the software which we are more concerned is Turnitin and that Urkun demo tool.